Hello everyone, High Priestess May here from PriestessMay.com. I wanted to go live because since doing my recent video messages, I have gotten a lot of new followers, a lot of new people that have come on my page. And I've gotten a lot of people that have asked me the same question, so I wanted to go on and answer it. I'm just gonna wait for a few of you to come on. Hey, how are you? How are ya? Light Roma, hello. Hello. So hello and welcome to everyone. Just a blanket hello to everyone. So since I did the readings, I've gotten, like I said, a lot of new followers. And I wanted to, and I keep getting the same question. And it is, what is my ethnicity? Okay, so I'm gonna tell you guys a little bit about me. So I am what's called a first generation Caribbean American. So that means that my whole family before me and before my brothers and cousins, my whole family before us are completely from the Caribbean. I'm from Dominican Republic. My whole family is from a small town in Dominican Republic, which you might actually see me visit a few times when you follow me here. I visited, I think, last year, and I have footage of that on my Instagram. But I'm from a small town. Can you hear me? Hello. So I'm from a small town in Dominican Republic called San Francisco de Macorís. It's about a half hour from Santiago and about 3 hours or so from Santo Domingo. So that's where I'm from originally. I was born in the Bronx, but I grew up there until I was about 10 years old. I grew up there with my mom and my grandparents until I was about 10 years old. And then at that point, my parents actually decided to move back to New York. And I lived in New York City for a long time. And then my parents moved up to upstate New York, which is like a little town in upstate New York called Walden. There's actually a book about it. So there's a little town in upstate New York called Walden. It's a really beautiful little town. That's where I finished growing up, I guess you could say, and where I met my spouse. So being from the Caribbean, I am of mixed heritage, which means that I am Spaniard, African, and a little bit of Native Taíno or Native American, whichever way you want to put it. So being from Dominican Republic, a lot of people who are originally from Dominican Republic, at least from my generation and from my parents' generation, have mixed heritage of African and Native American and Spaniard. Particularly from my father's side of the family, I'm a lot more Spaniard and Romanian. And then my mom has mix of, from her mom's side. Her mom's side is Spaniard and Portuguese. And then my grandfather's side is Yoruban, Congolese, Egyptian, and a little bit of Taíno. So there's a lot of mixing that happened, because all the mixing happened about 5 generations ago. And then it just kept happening. So I was born in the Bronx, but I grew up in Dominican Republic because that's where my family's from San Francisco de Macorís. If you ever have a chance to visit, it's a very cute little small town. It's not as rustic as it used to be. Now it's very popular. A lot of people live there. There's a lot of open markets. There's a lot of people on mopeds. You'll notice that. A lot of people riding motorcycles. It is kind of like right outside. It's like right kind of like inside of a whole bunch of farms and stuff where people grow a lot of their food. It is a very poor town, but everybody's happy, which is really, really beautiful. And most people don't really go there, because most people go to like the tourist attraction sides, like Nagua or Puerto, what's it called? Jeez, I'm blanking. Punta Cana and a whole bunch of the other tourist locations. But Where I'm from is like, oh, Puerto Plata. Thank you. I blanked a little bit. But most people go to, like I said, to like those areas, but they don't usually go because I'm kind of like in between mountains. So where we're from is like a city in between mountains. So doesn't usually get visited a lot, but it is a beautiful, happy city. There's a lot of history there. It looks very much like, if you've ever been to St. Augustine, it looks a lot like St. Augustine in some areas because it was colonized. So it does look a little bit Spaniard. Let me see, what else am I thinking? But yeah, that's me. So that's who I am. That's what I am. That's for anybody who wanted to know, because everybody was like, why do you look so mixed? And it's because I am mixed. I love everybody because I can relate to a lot of people from different areas and different places. Everybody is welcomed here from any walk of life. So if you guys are just looking to have a drama-free zone and that is accepting and welcoming of all beliefs, I love to learn about all different types of spiritual, cultural beliefs and history, because I am so mixed from so many different places. I love to learn about different people from different places. I'm in my backyard. This is my backyard in Florida. So I actually live in Florida now. I've lived in Florida for the last couple of years, probably almost 3.5 years. I've lived in Florida. Before that, I lived in New York. And I lived in upstate New York. So there was a lot of mountains, it felt very, very similar to living in Dominican Republic because the area was very similar as opposed to the busyness of like the Bronx and Manhattan. And my parents lived in Queens for a long time. So it was a little bit different, but it was fun. So that's me. So, just know that no matter where you're from, you're welcomed here, because I probably am a little piece of everybody. whether you're more African, or whether you're more European, or whether you're more Native Taino, or Native American, I have a little bit of everybody in me because of where I come from. I'm from the Caribbean, and we're all about positive vibes and all about living like today is your last day, and kind of like, hey, are you going to meet your creator today? Were you nice today to other people? So that's what we are all about. So many, many blessings and love to you all. Thank you for following me. Thank you for being such a positive light in my life. Thank you for allowing me to share my gift with you. Just thank you for everything. So many blessings to you. And I hope that if there's anything that I can help you with, you can always book a session with me on priestessmay.com. And another thing, some people have also asked me if I would do readings for people like in that are incarcerated or people who are of different walks of life. Yes, I'm open. I am not judgmental. So whatever, if it's able to be done via phone, I will do it for you as long as they let me through. Because everyone has a right to connect to their spirit guides. Everyone has a right to connect to their their loved ones on the other side. So if you need to speak to me and you're anywhere in the world, I connect to everybody. I do talk to people in the entire world. I've had people that I've done readings for in Korea, in India, in Dubai. This one girl, poor thing, she wasn't allowed to talk to me, so she had to like hide under her, like in her closet in Dubai, to talk to me. I talk to people from all over the world. So if you would like to book a session with me, you can do so on priestessmay.com. And sending you much love and blessings. Bye-bye.